This is the Microsoft Arc Touch mouse. And for those who doesn't know about it, it's a wireless mouse that switches on when it's bent and switches off when it's flat. I'm quite surprised to see the lack of coverage of the mechanism that's inside. So I'm very excited because today we will be tearing this down completely. And trust me, you will be impressed. I've had this for a few years and the matte finish has deteriorated and become quite sticky under the humid weather. I'm using isopropyl alcohol to wipe the coating off all sides until it's not sticky anymore. And right off the bat, we remove the battery cover and the two AA batteries. They could have gone with a simpler design like my other mouse to lock the cover in place. But instead, they made this, which definitely feels higher quality. The 0.45mm diameter pin provides a spring force, and the small plastic can be taken out after the pin is removed. I will then peel off the label containing the product info and the safety certificates. I remove the two screws under the label, and the plastic strap, and then the double-sided tape, because I don't want to be surprised by any hidden screws before I pry the button cover off. And there are four undercuts holding it in place. The red wire and the flat circuit were pulled out as I was forcing this open. The two halves can be completely separated after the haptic vibrator connector is unplugged. And then I can pry the haptic vibrator out from the underside of the button cover. The next thing that's coming off is this rubber gasket. 16 plastic studs are melted and form into a mushroom shape which clamp the gasket in place. This process is called heat staking. Do you know the purpose of this gasket? Have a guess while I use a knife to cut the studs off the two plastic parts clamping the gasket. It might be easier to know the answer if you have this in hand. There is a gap around each button to allow them to flex when they are pressed, and the flexible gasket seals the gap without restricting the motion of the buttons. The light guide can be removed in a similar manner. The scroll wheel button is stuck to the button cover with double-sided tape. I also have to cut open a plastic joint hidden at the top before I can push it out. A mechanical scroll wheel is out of the question in this design, because the mouse only measures 14.3mm at the thickest point. Microsoft used an array of capacitive sensors to detect the speed and the direction of our finger scrolling. And the haptic vibrator that we saw earlier mimics a notchy feedback that we would get from a mechanical scroll wheel. Listen to this. I use a knife to separate another double-sided tape between the sensor and the 1mm thick cover before I pull everything off the button cover. And this is how the flat circuit looks like when it's completely flat. I love looking at flat circuit design because the designer can get really creative to include different functionalities and connect to different bits of the device together with the same piece of circuit. Another connector can be unplugged. I can then desolder all the wires connecting the battery terminals to the PCB before removing the PCB from the undercuts on the housing. And a small piece of foam on the PCB separates the flat circuit from the Bluetooth antenna, so they don't touch or interfere with each other. The optical components of the infrared sensor and the Bluetooth button can be removed. And this black piece of tape covers this hole, so that the PCB will not be visible when the battery cover is open. I also remove the four battery terminals from the housing before finally moving on to the bending mechanism. Three pairs of screws from the top and another pair from the bottom can be removed. The mechanism hangs onto the housing by three metal pins that are solidly molded into the housing. These pins make the bending more durable than to just rely on the screws to take the repeated mechanical stress introduced during bending. And only after prying this piece of plastic off also, the whole rubber skin can be pulled off. This plastic might seem trivial at first, but it actually serves two purposes. You probably know the first reason already, and that is keeping the rubber skin in place. Secondly, is the foot of the mouse. When the mouse is bent, the plastic rests on the table so the tip of the rubber skin doesn't. And this is actually very important because we would have a hard time moving the mouse around if it was the rubber that's rubbing on the table because rubber tends to stick. There is a sheet metal and a hard plastic part embedded into the rubber skin during the molding process. Do you have a guess of what's happening inside? Let's find out. But the banding doesn't work on its own, so I'm putting it back with the housing to illustrate this better. Four screws holding down the top piece of stainless are removed, and I notice there's a magnet hiding inside. The strange shape of the magnet can be seen under the magnet viewing film. I remove another two screws before taking the bottom stainless off, and it becomes very clear how this mechanism works. The stainless at the top surface holds this group of black and white plastic parts together, with a small gap between each segment. It also fixes the length of the top side. Meanwhile, the length of the bottom side is defined by the position of the free end of the bronze brackets. As we bend the mouse, this end of the bracket leaves the first position, moves down the plastic and gets stuck in the second position, and effectively reduces the arc length of this side. Because we now have a difference in length between the top and the bottom, the arc shape of the mouse is formed, and the shape is maintained by the magnets. The remaining two metal sheets and the four screws can be removed, and I cannot figure out by myself the purpose of these cutouts on the stainless. And I'd appreciate it very much if someone could let me know down in the comment section if you have any idea. But I do know the reason why the stainless are essential in this design. Imagine if they weren't here. When I'm bending the mouse, my thumb would be pushing the grippy rubber skin up against the bronze bracket and stopping it from sliding smoothly. The stainless separates the rubber from the bracket and provides a low friction sliding interface. We have two screws holding down the bronze bracket, which can be taken out after some wiggling. And bronze is chosen here because it has a low coefficient of friction on plastic and stainless. There is also a tiny bit of grease on the surface of the bracket to help reducing the friction. This tiny bend on the bracket interacts with the micro switch on the small PCB. I will cut away the two heat staking studs to take the PCB out. And this plastic is found under the PCB. I'm sorry I cannot figure out why this sheet is here, but please help me out and let me know down in the comments if you know why. The snappiness of the bending mechanism is produced by this group of magnetic parts. There is a steel part on each end of the range that acts as the end stop, and the slider that follows the free end of the bronze bracket is formed together by two plastic parts, two steel parts, and one magnet. And finally, three screws can be removed from the very end. I apologize for not decomposing this any further, because I know I will not be able to put this back together if I damage all the heat staking joints. There are over 70 components, including 23 screws in this mouse, but there are already 8 different types of screw. And it took me around 45 minutes to put everything back together. But I still have to say, the design is exceptional and is perfectly executed by the engineers. The teardown of this mouse did not disappoint me, and if you stayed for the whole video, I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. Please consider subscribing to keep updated on other fun products that I will tear down. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video.